We made our way to Broadway once again, Les Miserables, now entering its ninth year. Two new stars in it, a lady by the name of Catherine Hicklin.
My childhood in history. Yes. Yes, I will marry you.
Is Catherine Hicklin.
It's your nose. Yep. I'm gonna play with it because it's driving me crazy. It's made out of rubber. Oh, look at that. Look how far it stretched. All right, so this is how it's gonna work. I'm gonna snap it back. I'm gonna let it go. It snapped back and hit you in the face and put you into a deep sleep. Are you ready? I've done this hundreds of times. No, actually thousands, right, Scott? Okay, here we go. Sleep all the way down. Give him a big round of applause. Yes, dude. What happened?
I don't know.
He was 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch. Daylight come and we want to go home. 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch.
Right away, what the heck are you? What is your name?
Anthony,
what are you doing?
I don't know.
Wide awake! Dude, what are you doing?
Make sure you turn around and wave goodbye to the people.
Questions after the show. I really actually love that. They ask me all kinds of things, but the question I think that they ask me the most is this: what's it like to date a hypnotist? Well, I'm very married, but it is a fun little bit, and it's easier for me to show you than to tell you. usually have quite a long line after a show because I have fans from the TV shows I've been on over the years. And it's important to me to have a connection with each and every one of them. Because they came there, they spent their money, they spent their time, and they want to meet me at that moment. I am not leaving until every single one of them gets what they came for, the picture, the experience. And I love people, so this makes my job really easy. I remember Maya Angelou said something once that I never forgot, and I think it's really true. She said, it's not the things that you say that people will remember, but the way you made them feel. And for me, when I have young people or I have older people, and when the world is a little bit of a scary place and people feel anxiety, it's really my job to make them understand that their mind is a powerful thing. And yes, we make people laugh like this, but I also leave them with something that's very special. I call it the gift, and it's for them to know that they can achieve anything that they put their mind to, and that they are very important.
Okay. Hello. I am sure that you probably can hear me right now, and you can see me too, and happy Saturday. This is my favorite night of the week for no particular reason, except I always have Love Saturdays. I know I have tomorrow off. I know that there's nowhere else I'm supposed to be except right next to Todd in bed with our computers on watching a movie and going, hey, whatever happened to that person? I don't know. Google it. So I'm super happy to be here on one of my favorite nights of the week. And this is so much easier for me to do on a Saturday night, this show. It's not in sync? Okay, I can't tell because, all right. Ryan? So, okay, so we're not in sync. We're going to try. Do we have to start all over? Not in sync. Okay, let me know if I'm back in sync, because that is very distracting. And we have an exciting giveaway show tonight, so I want to make sure that I am in sync. Let me know. Okay, so am I in sync? We're trying to get it in sync for the rest of the show. But we have about we're good now?
Yeah.
We're good. All right, so we have a great, fun show tonight because we have a really exciting giveaway and an auction. As usual, we have an auction once a week, and tonight I'll start it off with the auction. I hope everybody had a good week. Do let me know, and we're going to start off with the auction. There you are.
Well, I'm going to have to change a few hats on and off.
I know. You know why? Because Todd is star, producer, technical. He's technical director tonight because we don't have anybody in that seat. Everybody was busy tonight or not feeling well, but the show must go on. So Todd will be cameraman, host, and loving husband. Okay, so that will be tonight's show. So if it seems a little off tonight, it's because it's... Oh, my gosh. Right in your ear.
Camera 2.
Okay. What's that?
Camera 2.
Look at me.
Look
at those eyelashes I had.
I like the freckles.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. And Dora is here, so it's Todd, Dora, and myself.
Explain to people what is it that we're looking at. Wave, Dora.
I want to say this is me at around 2. Oh, hold on. 1958. I'm exactly 2. 2 years old.
And you know what I'm doing right in August?
You're 6 months old. So there you have it. That's our secret. I'm a cougar. I'm 2 years older, almost 2 years older than my husband.
Year and a half,
but still. So that's me at 2. Now, on the back of that, my Nana, who of course was my grandmother, she wrote something on the back of it.
I have that actually. Oh, I don't even have myself turned on because I had some other things to do.
Well, turn yourself on, man. For God's sake, turn yourself on.
We do have the back of that.
So this is me at 2 and
well,
Todd
I don't know why I don't know.
Old.
I don't know if it's a good idea. I don't, you know, I had a hard time reading it. Is what.
Oh, well, you don't have to put it
no,
up
No, I'll
there.
Put it up there.
You
I just,
read it.
Well, no, it's going to be, here it is.
Okay, let's see. So on the back, my Nana wrote this, which kind of gives you an idea of the oddity of me. She's looking down at a book, where it says.
Okay, there it is.
Yeah. Doesn't this look like a Walt Disney character? Well, that's pretty funny. She carries a book of arts. Over, she carries a book of arts around about the moon and stars and says, look, Nanny, outer space. 2.5. She's always talking about outer space and the moon. It sounds so funny coming from such a little thing. And then it says in parentheses, I yike you, because I would walk around all the time saying, I yike you to people. And that meant I like you. And apparently I said it to everybody.
I still think you should do that. It's a trademark.
I yike you?
I like it.
Yeah.
It's a trademark item.
I yike you. And then if I could say, I don't yike you.
Put that hair back.
Okay.
No, right here. This part.
Okay.
This one right here. Right there. We got it.
Got it? Okay, see, I don't have time before a show to get myself perfect. But this is amazing because at 2.5, I had a book and talked about the stars. By 3, I knew all of the planets in the solar system in their order. And so I was a weird kid.
It's useful information when, you know.
That is weird.
When
you know?
Take your first astronomy yeah. class,
so,
it counts.
So, but it makes sense to me about the mind I have today. And just like at three, I literally knew the order of the planetary system. And I still do. I don't know. I was always fascinated with the universe. Even
what's
at
the closest planet to the sun?
Mercury.
And next?
Venus.
Next?
Earth.
I think it's Mars, isn't it?
Wait.
It has to be Mars.
Sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter.
Then why is Mars hotter?
Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto. Those are the orders of the planets I think I'm right about that.
I think
that.
Mars might be, it's hotter, Mars, so seems like it would be closer if it's hotter.
Right, but it's not.
Actually, it's either that or they are experiencing global warming there because of the carbon footprint.
Right.
Of
oh,
all
I
the
do,
alien I, carbon footprint is driving up the temperature on Mars.
I love you, Dora. Yeah, but anyway, I think that's where Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars. So
would have been a good trivia question, I'll tell you that
it
much.
It would have been a good one. So there you have it. Hey, Bill Tuscalis is here tonight. Latest Dora Elena Fernandez, who is right here. Debbie Star Jackson says, I yike wieners. That's a good one, Debbie. She means winners. I just wanted to let you know. Don Renta, and your sister's here tonight, Doriana Fernandez, and Ferruccio is here tonight, like Dora's trademark is a wiener. Ferruccio, so stinking cute. Thank you, Maria Smith Garvin. You should see the tattoo she got on the side. It's Carrie, and it is fantastic. Beautiful, beautiful. I'm going to take a picture of it and show it one night if it's okay with you, Maria.
Speaking
you
of Carrie, there's Carrie as a teenager.
Oh, my gosh. And there's you playing the guitar right up here in the dark, right?
Yep. Well, sort
in
of.
In the shadow.
Now, that sounds more like it.
Isn't that interesting?
In the shadows.
Isn't that interesting?
She was singing Bridge Over River Kwai. And
Bridge Over the Troubled Waters. And then she
which turned out to be the bridge over the River Kwai.
But she ended up marrying
Paul
the person
Simon.
That wrote that song.
The
That's
person.
That's weird.
He is the person.
That is amazing. She ended up marrying Paul Simon. Okay, so are we out of sync again, as people are saying? No, we're good?
I can't imagine.
Okay.
The way you do that, though, is look at the camera and count. 1, 2.
1, 2, 3, 4, Five.
Shut the door. Five, six, pick up sticks.
Oh, I remember that. Whoops. Okay, so let me just watch this. All right, so hello, Kathy Winkler, Shannon Marie, Nikki, Ryan Clements, who produced tonight's show with Dora and did an amazing job because, you know, he has a very full-time job, and this isn't easy. It looks as easier than it is. And Ryan and Dora, you both work super hard too.
But now that the show really, is officially
really
open, we could show.
Now we're going to do that at the end.
What?
Yeah. What we're putting online.
No, I was going to say we could throw in the little nightlight film clip because it's only a few minutes
okay.
long.
Okay. So let me do this then.
Okay,
let me start with the auction, and then I will set up that clip for you, or
okay.
you can set it
it's
up for
It's only
yourself.
A couple of minutes.
All right, but I want to get this started. Because
unless people would rather, you know, I mean.
No, I want to do this because, you know, this is our one night auction. I mean, we do only one auction a week, so let me do this. So let me just do this. The Debbie Bundle.
Picture.
Yes, you have a picture. So Dora. The wiener has a picture.
So we're doing the Debbie Bundle.
So we're going to do the Debbie Bundle. Let me see if I can do this without dropping
By the way,
anything. Okay, this is
shoot
absolutely...
Shoot them horizontal when you can.
This is astonishing to
unless,
me.
Unless it... No, you know what? I take that back. Sometimes this works.
Oh, yeah. And then we'll cut to that camera?
We're going to have to get in close.
Yeah.
Unless
no,
you...
I've got
did
it.
You shoot any
no,
close
I've
up?
I've got it in my hand.
Yeah, but I... Okay.
Okay. All right. So, what do we have here? Oh, where's the camera right there?
Well, I mean, here, I'll change it close.
Okay. Okay, here we go.
Lift it up a little bit.
All right, let me just, I got to hold it.
Here, let's
place.
Get rid of that. Let's do one thing at a time.
One thing at a time. So, this was, first of all, this is such a cool idea. This was actually an invitation to something.
I have a close-up picture. Okay, well, you can see there
and
it is.
It was a cigarette. Oh, I have my fingerprints on it. So it was a cigarette case.
It is. Still is a
and
cigarette case.
It still case. Is. But it was an invitation to something, which I don't have my
No, it says it on there.
Well, yeah, that'd be great if I could read it.
It says that
these on.
It was, P. Pervin and Associates Company. I think it's an agency.
Yeah.
It was at Robertson Plaza, inaugural, whatever that means. I mean, I know
it
what inaugural means, but I mean,
of
yeah, of something. But Parvin and Dohrmann Company.
Okay.
Robertson Plaza, inaugural, and 12, it's 120 North Robertson Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, February 1967.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a silver.
So this is from 1967. It's,
but look how beautiful it is.
Oh,
it's a silver
it is
cigarette box.
So it's a cigarette box. And then Todd had the idea to put something in it, which is awesome. So Debbie was not a smoker.
Well,
she liked to
she
pretend.
Cheated. She puffed.
She did cheat, but you want to
she
know
puffed.
Something? She puffed. I don't think I ever saw her inhale. In fact, even towards the end, every now and then she would, these are actually her cigarettes because we had a pack of her Virginia Slims left. So don't smoke this because it's old.
Well, I don't think it just probably
oh,
does.
Oh, no, no. This, well, let's figure this out. This Christmas,
there.
They'll be gone for
so,
4 years.
So here's the close-up of the lid.
That's
the inside.
Of the lid.
And
then on the inside, I don't know if she had time to photograph this, if Dora had time to photograph. Yes, she did. Awesome. There it is. So he put, I don't know how many, 10 of Debbie's last pack of cigarettes in there. And then also 2 of her old matches. One
hold,
set.
I'll go camera 4. There
okay,
you go.
Okay, one set with her name on it.
Now these are rare because these were her personal matches.
I know, but I love this golden one with her name.
And it still has the old stick matches. There's the stick matches inside.
Yep. So I love this. It is really great.
It's
so
a smoking package.
And she kept this on her table in the living room. And then the next item in the same bundle. Now, what would you use this for?
Well,
this
it could
is a neat little table.
It would be used for a coaster. I mean, you can.
You could put jewelry in it. You could put a candle in it.
You could, but it also could serve as a coaster. But it was, I don't know if you could see how ornate
it
is.
I'll put it behind the black.
And this, in my view, is pure silver. The other one, I believe, is plated.
Right, but this is a beautiful piece. Dora polished it up because it was, you can see it in the picture.
I'll tell you what my mother did with it.
What?
She had some glass ashtrays, and I'll provide one with it that would sit in that. So it was sort of like a coaster for a glass ashtray.
Yeah, I remember this being on her coffee table in her living room. And then, the third item in that same bundle is a pair. Debbie did not have pierced ears, and she wore, though she had a lot of real jewelry, she wore costume jewelry because she was always afraid she was going to lose something since she didn't have pierced ears. So this was a piece of her costume jewelry, and this is in the same bundle. They're pretty, aren't they? And then on top of that is a copy of Singing in the Rain.
The truth is, those look pretty good. It's not just any.
Oh, they're beautiful. That's
not just,
I love costume jewelry.
That's not just any copy of Singing in the Rain.
No, it's a signed copy by Debbie. So the signed copy of Singing in the Rain comes.
That's a DVD that was.
Yes.
Now, this is not Blu-ray, but it's because it would be, this was pre-Blu-ray.
Right.
But she had signed these when she was touring, and she would sign these and they would sell them out front, or she would sign them out front. So this happens to be one I found the other day. There's only a couple of these in our little inventory. So this is a very rare signed DVD edition.
And you threw DVD that part edition. In at the last minute. So
I did it because I didn't feel, I wanted to connect.
Everything.
Let me have the cigarette case for a second. I wanted to see I wanted the cigarette case. You know, I wanted someone to be able to do something special where they could show. This is a stunning piece.
Oh, I love
that. And the bottom
that.
Is all engraved as well. You see, let me go to this. I'll do your camera for that. But you can see the bottom. You see all that in tooling in that. I mean, this is a truly beautiful. I mean, if I had, not that I smoke, but if I did, I would, I would keep this. It reminds me. This actually came from the Palm Springs house, where it ended up.
It's very old Hollywood, which is what
but
I
it,
love
it was. It ended up at Palm Springs, so I have some other things to match. But that was kind of that's a serious Debbie bundle. So
that is a serious.
I'm not sure.
Debbie bundle.
I mean, the earrings were a little on the fringy side, but that really fleshes it out.
Oh, I love those.
That's
and
like
then
a
the
whole
last
collection.
Thing in it, does this go with it? Mm-hmm. Okay, so the last piece in this bundle are. Is a picture of Todd and Todd signed it, and I will sign it up here. So that is the Debbie bundle. If you want to bid on that, it's the Debbie bundle, and just started at, it's dry today. Started at $5.
Mm-hmm. Now, while we're talking about Debbie, let's go ahead and announce the other Debbie item that we've been talking about for a couple of weeks.
We're going to talk about that at the end of the show.
All right.
And then,
that's what I said. Let's not talk about that.
That's right.
Let's make sure
producers.
Not to talk about that item. There is an item coming that we're going to be talking about.
Right. But that's
it's an item the Ferruccio was very interested in talking about.
But we're going to talk about that at the end of the show. So the second bundle is a cat bundle. And you have One Life to Live script signed by Hillary B. Smith, who played Nora, and myself. We also have a Knight Rider script, the first one that I was in, called White Bird. And that script will be signed by me. And then we have a picture of me, which I will sign. And we also have something really awesome that goes with that bundle. This is the new, this is the new crossbody bag. And Francine, we have your crossbody bag that's going out today, in case you're watching. Or is it going out
Monday?
So this crossbody bag has this on it right now, but it also has a very long
belt.
Not belt, but it makes it into a crossbody bag. This is made for cell phones, so you can fit just about any size.
I might want that.
Cell phone in that. Isn't it beautiful? And the leather is just
remember when guys
soft.
Used to carry around little bags like that? little purses?
Merces, we called them, merces. So inside the leather cell phone, inside the leather cell phone.
Can it fit my blaster in there?
It doesn't fit your blaster.
My blaster doesn't fit. Lift it up a little bit. So the truth is, though, if you had a smaller gun, it would fit in there.
Yeah, but it is so beautiful. This is a brand new crossbody bag that we just got in, and we're going to put a katana of your choice. And it comes.
Will it hold a lightsaber? Could the lightsaber fit in there? I think it would hold your lightsaber.
You think so?
It's good for a lightsaber hiding.
Not quite.
This is what's called a concealed lightsaber bag for concealing your lightsabers.
So what do you get in it? You get no baggage, which is one of my favorite products in the world. You also get, a man could use this for sure, but it's a cell phone wallet crossbody bag. There's there's many pockets inside of it, and also
lift it up so you can see.
Also a place for 6 credit cards inside of it. Okay, you can grab me that. And then you also, besides the no baggage, you will get
this
a
is very plush
pencil.
Inside.
Oh, it's plush in and out. It's super soft leather. And then you get a truffle pencil and the sharpener. You get the no baggage. You get the mascara. And you get 2 new items that we have not debuted yet. I will show them to you right now. So these are for your lips, your eyes, and your face. This is beige lights in a new... it's like a real neat skinny stick. And then here's the, that is bronze lights. Beige lights is the one you get in the fat stick, but they're in skinny sticks. And here's bronze lights. Let me show it to you before I do this. So bronze lights, if you can see that, is a cream bronzer for your face.
Roll your wrist.
Your face.
Roll it.
I'm trying.
No, just like that.
Okay.
That way you get
that's the only way I can do
it. Yeah,
it.
Then you can see the shimmer.
Yeah. So, but it's got just the right amount of shimmer in it. You can wear it on your lips. You can wear it on your face, your eyes. And it comes
I went to the pouch. Just
okay,
for
great.
Full screen.
So you can see it there, but those are products that we haven't even listed yet, and they are absolutely amazing. So you basically have an entire face color, lip color, and eye color.
I talked about this. I thought it was like an opportunity to own a product kind of before it hits the general market. You could do that with that guy stuff too.
Yep, we'll do that. We're releasing our man line near Black Friday. We're still putting everything in it, but it's amazing. But those products. So they all fit in the bag with your cell phone, and you also get with the cat bundle the Elastin Collagen Cream, which forget about it, it's the best moisturizer ever. And I say that with all humility, only because I don't think I've ever had a jar returned, which is pretty amazing. Cat Cosmetics only has a 1% return rate to begin with. So, it's remarkable because makeup is very tactile, and so it's great. But you always have 30 days to return something. No questions asked, no love lost, right? So the Cat Bundle, which is an amazing deal, at any price, but start the bidding on the Cat Bundle at $5 and make it $5 increments. And which one? My bundle, okay.
Well, I was going to say that purse. In if you
oh,
were
no, that wallet. That,
if you were shopping,
it's a purse,
but I'm saying I would pay, decent money just for that. And then you get to own the products are not actually in the market yet.
A couple
of them.
The sticks are not available on the market yet.
So that's kind of a fun thing. I like that. If somebody I never really get a chance to have something before it's in the general market.
I know,
I'd like to see you do that with the guy stuff. How many of the guys would like to see her? She's about to come out with a guy line. We could do the same thing.
It's a guy kit, and it is unbelievable.
I think that bag. Guys.
I
want to try that bag.
Awesome. Well, you know what's amazing about it? It fits any cell phone. And it has a long leather strap, too, that you can, put on this beautiful hardware. That's
but I could
on
carry
it.
Some
it's
other tools
leather.
In there and stuff.
You could
guy
carry
tools.
Anything in there.
We could have a Swiss Army knife in
it's
there.
It's an awesome bag. It has zippers inside and out and a place for 6 credit cards. And you know what? I get neck aches from carrying my heavy purses around with me, and I have learned I don't need everything with me all the time, and I literally get neck aches, and I would like to announce to you my headache has gone away.
So lay that down in the seat before it falls off.
This?
Yeah, just that's right.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so that's it. Bundles are off and running. I just want to thank everybody for that. Now, I do want to say that I'm really excited because we have a friend of ours who is, he's got a show here on the Las Vegas Strip, and his show is called The Mentalist, and he is so talented. It is one of the best mind reading shows, and it is so, it's such an amazing show, and I've known him since 2004. We've been friends since our New York days. I actually saw his first big off-Broadway show, and it was really, really fun. And that's actually where we met and became friends. He was on a NBC TV reality show in 2007 called, I think it was called Phenomenon, and it was mentalists competing against each other. It was fantastic. He also had his own NBC special in 2004. He's been Las Vegas headliner for over 16 years. He's done over 4,000 shows here in Las Vegas.
And here he is, ladies and gentlemen, live. Oh, that's not what's happening?
No, he's not here live.
Oh, I thought that it sounded like he was about to walk in the room.
And no, but he's just a great performer. Now, why am I bringing this up? Because we're not able to have shows, any of us, any entertainers are not allowed to do shows because of COVID. He has created a virtual show that he is going to be premiering on this Wednesday. I'm not sure what that date is. What is this Wednesday? If somebody could look that up for me. So this Wednesday night at 7:00 PST, Pacific time, he's debuting The Mentalist Live in virtual. So he has so kindly given me tickets to give away. Now, we're going to be giving them away to you in different ways. Let me just get this straight, because we're giving away about 25 tickets, which is, it's so exciting because you're going to see the very first one. Otherwise, you'd have to pay to go see this show. But he donated these because we're friends and he's an awesome person. And so we're going to give them away in different ways, all right? So let's do this. Let's show Jerry. We have a clip. Let's show what he does. I love this routine. I love this routine I'm about to show you.
Twins share a certain bond between them. It's a special energy that runs through their lives. To demonstrate this, I've invited a set of identical twins here. You may recognize them. They're the Coors Light Twins. I want you to take part in a little experiment. In a moment, I'm going to ask you to close your eyes down, and you're not going to open your eyes until I ask you to. You will feel certain things, you will experience certain sensations. Remember where you actually feel it, and how many times you feel it happening. Keep your eyes closed and trust me. You're in good hands. Close your eyes down tight now. Keep them closed. Take both your hands. Extend them out in front of you with your fists nice and tight locked. Perfect. If you felt something lightly touching your arm, nod your head. Take the opposite arm and point to where you felt it happen. Interesting. keeping your eyes closed. If you felt something touch you on your shoulder, raise your left arm. Use your fingers and indicate how many times you felt tapped. Take both of your hands and extend them out in front of you in a cupped position. Bringing your hands up to your nose and inhale. What is it that you smell?
Smells like a rose.
Put your hands on your lap. What I'm about to do to one twin, the other twin will experience tenfold.
That was cute.
I love that, love that, love that. And this is the kind of thing that you will get to see. And also what's great about a virtual interactive show with any of these kind of shows, but Jerry is going to actually do things with everybody in the room or give everybody a chance to experience what it's like to not only see a mentalist show, but be part of a mentalist show. So watch your thoughts. And we're going to give away these tickets now. I'm super excited. This show, I'm going to be there too. Of course, I will be there because it's his first show. Now, what's that?
I just happened to stumble on it. It's Carrie on a boat.
I love it.
Here in Vegas,
okay.
Out of Lake Mead.
Let me give these.
Notice what's in her hand.
What's in her hand? A Coke. Look at that. All right, so here we go. The giveaway. First, we're going to do we want to do the first five people or the trivia?
Well, the first five people that is signed here.
Okay, so Ryan decided that the first five tickets are going to go to the first five people that signed in tonight. That's random, and I love that. So, Cheryl Davidson Conway, you have won.
But wait, are these? Oh, that's right. You can be anywhere and go to this show.
Yeah, you can be anywhere and go to this show.
Okay, so it doesn't. You don't have to.
I will send you your invitation that allows you to. Go to the show, and you're going to need a few things, Cheryl. So I'll send you an email, and it'll tell you what you need to have in front of you to participate in the show. Very simple stuff you should have around the house. And they, oh, good. And Cheryl really wants to be there.
Well, I mean, like,
oh, yeah. If you are not interested in going, if I announce your name, do me a favor and donate the ticket back because we want to make sure that he has a full house and he is so dedicated to giving these tickets to me. So we don't want to waste any tickets. So Cheryl Davidson Conway, by the way, you can have other people in the room with you. So as long as you can fit people in front of the computer, it can be other people besides you, but you will be the person participating in the show. All right, number two, Vicki Giddens, you have won a ticket to the show. Please let us know if you plan to attend. It is this Wednesday night coming at 7 p.m., right?
October 7th or October 6th?
October 7th, isn't it? What's Wednesday? October 6th? Let me make sure I'm getting this right. Okay, I. Okay, it's Wednesday night.
Okay,
I think it's Wednesday night, and I'll double check that for you. So, Cheryl Davidson Conway and Vicki Giddens, you have won. Brenda and Chris McFamily, you were the third people to check in tonight. You have won a ticket. Patty Hughes, you are the fourth person to check in tonight. You have won a ticket, and you have seen Jerry live in Las Vegas. I know because we all went to see him one night from Get Your Fire Back. So that you're going to get to see the virtual show, which will be all new for you. Number five, Madia Smith Garvin, you were the fifth person to check in tonight, so you have won a ticket to The Mentalist Live. Now, the next group of tickets we are going to give away will be with trivia. So it's me, Ryan, Diane Vasquez, and Dora. We are going to be making sure that the right people win, meaning whoever gets the answer first, as we all see it. Here we go. First question, get your fingers on the keys. Oh man, this is a good one. Who was the voice of Kit on Knight Rider? Who was the voice of Kit on Knight Rider?
I have a good trivia question for you. Can I insert a new a surprise trivia question?
Yes, you can make it the sixth one. Hold on 1 second. I'm just going to concentrate on this. Okay, Vicky's excited to go. Oh, Brenda is really excited to go. The winners are excited to go.
Dora.
All right, so.
Dora.
Waiting for confirmation.
Dora.
You have to turn your mic off.
I will.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, I'm waiting for, okay. Okay, my confirmation, I know who I have first. Can I, who is your confirmation? Are you checking with Diane and Ryan? Mm-hmm. Okay. Sorry, guys, this takes a while, but I have mine. I'm did he text me?
Okay, it's Barb Kevern.
Barb Kevern? Mm-hmm. All right. Mine was, hold on. I don't know if I got the same one. Let me look. Okay, Shannon Marie was my first, so we're going to give Barb Kevern and Shannon Marie. And so those are the two tickets that will go to Barb Kevern and Shannon Marie. Congratulations, you are going to have a blast at this. Okay, number two, famous actor trivia. What actor played Marty McFly in the Back to the Future movies? Go. What actor played Marty McFly in the Back to the Future movies? All right. Mm-hmm. I have a lag on my phone. And waiting for confirmation. I'm really in a lag here. My first one just came through.
Why don't you just make it yours? Forget the confirmation.
No,
just
because we have to make it fair. Okay, we're waiting for confirmation. Who is it?
Rolla Bedford.
Rolla Bedford, you are the wiener. You get a ticket. I also have.
Do you want to
Don Renta? Don Renta and Terry Dixon were a tie on mine. So there's three tickets right there. So add three. Don Renta.
This was my trivia question.
And Terry Dixon. Oh, okay. You can't see it, though. All right.
No, so I haven't put up yet because I'm waiting for you to tell me if it's doable.
I like it. Okay. This is a hard one. Three. Who was the first African-American actor to win an Oscar? Do you know that?
I do.
Okay. And so there you go. First African-American actor to win an Oscar. And we're going to do one more off of this, and then your trivia question, and then we're going to move on to drawings. Okay. I have not gotten the answer yet. Who was the first African American actor to win an Oscar?
Okay, waiting for confirmation.
I have mine. Waiting for confirmation.
Can I see if I would get it right?
Yeah, but just wait a minute because
Well, you guys have, you already said you had people.
Okay, I'm just waiting for her to tell me. Yes, who is it?
Hattie McDaniels?
No, that was actress.
Oh, you said actor?
Yes.
Sydney Poitier?
Scott yes. Dresmel. Scott Dresmel, that's who I have as well. Todd Fisher and Scott Dresmel. You have won tickets, but it's just Scott's that counts because Todd.
I think it would have been more obscure to go for the woman.
Yes. Yes, it would have been, but you know, we're all doing the best we can on this. Now here we go. The last one before what is yours? But oh, okay, wait a minute.
Mine is this picture over your shoulder.
Okay, and they can't see the picture.
Not yet.
Okay, so go ahead and let's do yours.
Well, no, I'm going to show the picture.
Oh, okay.
What movie?
Yes.
Did Carrie make with John Belushi? She knows the answer.
Good one.
There's a cool picture right
good
here of Carrie with John. What movie did Carrie make with John Belushi?
What movie did Carrie
it's
make
It's also
with
where
John
they became
Belushi.
Very good friends.
Yes, lifelong friends.
True.
Until
unfortunately,
the end of his
well,
life.
No, for his entire life, for sure. Yeah. Yes.
You She's have a got wiener?
What's the name?
Wait. Okay. No. Angela Pritchett.
Angela Pritchett.
Blues Brothers. That is correct.
Carrie was the viciously aggressive ex-girlfriend that wanted to kill all of Belushi's. Every time he'd be around, she was upgrading her attack weapons. It's a really funny little part for Carrie. It's very cute.
All right. That was a good one, hon.
Well, it goes with a picture, which is fun, too.
Yes.
You know, when you can do that.
All right, so who's number five?
How many have you given away?
We're giving away 25-ish, okay? So who starred in Magnum P.I. in the 80s and now stars on CBS show Blue Bloods, which I haven't seen? What actor starred in Magnum P.I. in the 80s and now stars on Blue Bloods? The Blue Bloods. Let's see. Of course, if you've already won a ticket, you can't win another one. But, Maria, I know you say you couldn't help yourself because it's a Carrie question. All right. Bill Toscala says Carrie was awesome in that movie.
Okay, waiting for confirmation.
Okay, I'm waiting for the answer to come in. Mine is on a long lag. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Look at that picture I took.
Hmm? Oh.
A little snapshot of...
Tammy Anastasia, who just got out of surgery like day before yesterday, so now you'll have something really fun to watch on Wednesday night. I'm going to confirm that with Jerry right now on a text. So
Wednesday at 7?
Yes.
October 7th.
That's Jerry, right?
The video starts at 6 p.m.
6 p.m., even better. Sorry. So here it is, folks. I'm going to send you a... we're not done giving away tickets. I just wanted to reiterate because I got the time wrong. It's Wednesday night, the 7th, at 6 p.m. Pacific time, so 9 o'clock Eastern time. And the show is approximately an hour, I think, so still time to get some good sleep that night. So there is that. All right. So here's the last trivia. And then we're moving on to drawings. Number five, who was Johnny Carson's sidekick and announcer during his long-running show? Who was Johnny Carson's long-running sidekick during his show, The Tonight Show? And we will see if we can all match up on this answer. Here we go. I bet you I'm on a 10-second lag here. I think cell phones.
Yeah, waiting for confirmation now.
Jerry, thank you, Kat and Todd, for giving the tickets away. I love you guys. Thank you, Dora. I love you in a different way. Okay, so here we go. You're welcome, Tammy. And the answer.
Marcia Minor.
Okay, so now. And you're welcome, Jerry. You're super welcome. I love your show. It's so exciting to think people can come see this show by winning these tickets. I just wanted to let you know that Marcia Minor, you are the winner. I actually went to high school with Marcia Minor. So there you go. She was Marsha Durkin back then, I think. Okay, so that is that. Now we are going to pull some, we're going to do the drawings, right? All right, so how many tickets have we got left?
We have 14 given away.
Given away.
We have 6 more.
I'm going to let Todd.
The numbers that we have.
Oh, okay, you want to do numbers? Okay. All right, everybody, we're going to do numbers. I'm thinking of a number right now. It is a single-digit number. It's in my head, and now I'm throwing it to you. Let's see if you can read my mind. It's a single-digit number that I thought of before the show. So here we go. What is the single-digit number? I have it, and shall show it to you if you get it. I'm not seeing it yet.
Not yet.
You're not seeing it either?
Okay, waiting for confirmation.
Waiting for confirmation.
Okay.
Now, if you already won a ticket, you cannot win another one tonight. But I have somebody. Who do you have?
Tammy Wilson,
I have as well. It is number one. Congratulations, Tammy. You are the wiener. Okay. I'm thinking of a double-digit number, 2 digits. It's between 20 and 30, 2 digits, and they're both even-it digits. Both even-it digits. I'm thinking of them right now and chose it before the show. What are the two numbers I'm thinking about? Concentrate. Here we go. 2 digits between 20 and 30, both are double digits.
Okay, waiting for confirmation.
Waiting for confirmation.
Okay, Barbara Hammond.
Barbara Hammond, you are the winner. The number was 22. 22, Barbara Hammond. Congratulations, you are going to The Mentalist Live. Also, Jerry, will you do me a favor and text Dora your website as well? Text Dora your website exactly so I can let people know what it is. I'm now thinking of another number. It is a 2-digit number as well, 2-digit number between 90 and 99. And it is a 2-digit number. I'm thinking of it right now. Go ahead and put that on the screen below you at your name. Let's see if you are the winner of a ticket to The Mentalist Live. Okay. Waiting for confirmation.
Here.
Waiting for confirmation.
Here.
Oh. Tracy Saunders, you are, she's in Canada. Tracy Saunders is in Canada. You are the winner of a ticket to The Mentalist Live. And so what is the name of this website?
It's just mentalist.com.
Mentalist.com. If you want more information on Jerry or how you can buy a ticket to his show, you can go to mentalist.com. All right, so we got that. I have, again, a 2-digit number. A 2-digit number, 2 digits that are in my head, between 70 and 80, 2 digits, and both are odd digits. This ought to make it go kind of quick. Two that are odd digits, 2 digits between 70 and 80 for a ticket to The Mentalist Live.
Okay,
waiting for confirmation. I love this. This is such a fun giveaway. I can't stand it. It's going to be so fun. Kathleen Anderson, you are the winner. The number is 77. 77.
Sunset Strip.
77. Sunset Strip. Okay. Here we go. I'm thinking of a 2-digit number between 30 and 40. 2-digit number between 30 and 40. For if you guess this, you get a ticket to The Mentalist Live show on the 7th of October at 6 p.m., and you will get an email from me. Anyone that wins tonight, Please, if you haven't ever emailed me or Facebook messengered me your email, I'm going to need that to get your ticket to you. So please make sure you Facebook messenger, private messenger me your email address. All right. So have you gotten it yet?
Not yet.
Not yet. I have not either. Two-digit number between 30 and 40. Between 30 and 40. Waiting for confirmation. I have not gotten it yet, so by the time you confirm it, it usually pops right up on my screen. Maxine Moody, that's who I have as well. Maxine Moody, you have won. The number is 30. 30 is the number. Congratulations. I'm really excited. How many tickets have we given away?
Those are 20 already.
That is 20. Mm-hmm. So, Jerry, do me a favor. Text Dora the amount of tickets that we can give away.
Well, I think that's enough. I mean,
those are 20
already. We have given away 20. Is that our max number?
Here, I wanted to give you this now.
Oh, did I win?
You won today.
I won. You won at golf. See, I love this. We don't even have to get divorced for me to get half of your money.
You got half of my weenings.
I got half of your weenings. Wow. I can put my chickens through college now.
Yes, you can.
Okay, did you hear from Jerry yet?
Sorry, we have one more. I'm sorry.
Oh, we have one more?
One more to get the 20. So one more.
Okay, Jerry said 20 tickets. That's what we get?
No,
okay, Jerry will respond to you. And so we have one more. All right, so let's do a drawing. And with my really cool, is it taped down? It is.
Well, the thing about the drawings.
That's okay.
The thing about that came out. Look, take that one. It came out.
One just popped out.
That's what.
I don't recognize the name. We'll give you 30 seconds to respond. Gregory Kulhanajan. 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 It's that no good, huh? Yes. Yeah, because believe me.
He sounds, it's Armenian, I think. It's like,
yes. So if you are here tonight, then that is yours. And I'm going to check my messages just to see if I've heard from Jerry. Messages. Oh, I see. Okay, so here's Jerry. He said, the show is at 6, it starts at 6 p.m. It is a special viewing of The Mentalist with me giving commentary, but 7 p.m. starts the live show. That's cool. So it's actually from 6, it sounds like it's from 6 to 8 if you want to see what he's doing from 6 to 7. I think it's really interesting and really great. I would do that. Okay, we can give away 10 more tickets. 10 more. So let's do that, okay? So let's do that. Gregory, I haven't heard from.
Nope.
Okay, so here we go. Uh-huh. Here you go. Who won?
Judith don't know.
All right. Judith don't know. If you are here, please just write, I'm here, and then we will know. I'm going to keep picking.
You can just read it.
Debbie Johnson Strang, you're here. You have won a ticket. I'll put that there. Marcy Metelsky, if you are here, please write below, I'm here, because you have won a ticket. And if we don't hear from you, then we will give them away to others. Monica Meadows.
They're right here.
Here's these, Monica Meadows. If you are here, let us know. Okay. All right. Ravenna Greep, G-R-E-P-P. Ravenna Grip. If you are here, let us know. You have 30 seconds to claim. Donna Marie, I think you might be here tonight. I think I saw your name, Donna Marie. If you are here, say I'm here in the space below. Okay.
To give them time to
come. Oh yeah, no, I'm just reading, and if they're here.
Okay.
Yeah. Jan Painter. Jan Painter, if you're here, please put I'm here below. Brenda already won one. Stephanie Bonnert, B-O-H. Stephanie Bonnert, if you are here, let us know. Carol Grundy, if you are here, let us know.
Yeah,
I think
she's here.
I saw you, Carol, so I'm going to put that right there. Okay. Scott Edmondson. Scott Edmondson. I know you would love this show. I know Scott Edmondson personally. So Scott Edmondson, please claim it by saying I'm here. Bill Tiscalis is here tonight. You have won a show to The Mentalist Live. So there you go. And Ruben Garcia, definitely you have won a ticket to The Mentalist Live. And I will contact you because I know you were here earlier, but I don't know if you're still here. Okay. Marites Zurbano, I haven't seen you in here yet tonight. If you are here, say, I'm here. And let's see here. Erica D. Is Erica D here tonight? She's usually a regular. So Erica, let me know if you are here. I'm picking again. Anita Anderson. Anita Anderson, I think I saw you in the room earlier. You have won a ticket to Mentalist Live. This is so exciting. You all get to be together at the same show.
Okay, Carol Grandy, she said she cannot be at home to give it away.
Okay, then Kathleen Anderson, you have won a ticket to Mentalist Live. Now, how many of those people have we heard from? I think Kathleen is here tonight. Okay, so we're waiting, and then we will be done. Okay, so Carol Grundy is giving her ticket to Debbie Starr Jackson. So we want to write that down.
Only Debbie Strand and Bill Tatkinson.
Yep.
Are here.
All right. Kathleen Anderson is here.
Yeah.
Yep. So I've got.
Debbie.
Yep.
Five more.
Okay. And Linda Kornreich. Linda Kornreich, you are, even if you're not here, I know that you have seen Jerry live in Las Vegas many times. Linda Kornreich. Cheryl Murray, are you in the room? Cheryl Murray. Let me put these down here. Cheryl Murray. If you are in the room, you are a winner. Okay. Emily DeHope. If Emily DeHope is in the room, Emily usually is. Please, Emily, say, I'm here, below. You're welcome, Debbie Starr Jackson. That's right. Cheryl Murray is here. Yes. Okay. And the last name, in case we... is Dawn Ferry, our very good friend, Dawn Ferry. You know what, Dawn? I haven't seen you in here in a long time, but I think that you would love this. So, Dawn Ferry. And I'm going to draw just one more. Phyllis Marianos, if you are here, then go ahead and claim your ticket, and that's it. All right, so I'm just gonna look down and see what I claim. But the other night, I said someone's name, and I never saw her, but she, after the show, wrote me and said, hey, I was there, and then she won a $25 gift certificate and donated it back to the show. So we have so many great prizes for this Tuesday night. So that's the night before The Mentalist Live. So congratulations, all the winners, and we'll do all the other stuff that we usually do on Tuesday night's show. So let's see how we're doing on time. Hmm? Oh, Bill Tiscalis is giving his ticket to Seth Robichaux. Seth, you are going to love this show because I know you and you love this stuff, and it's going to be great. So thank you so much, everybody. And thank you, Jerry McCambridge, for donating the tickets, because this is going to be a hot ticket item for people to be able to still buy tickets to entertainment. And all of you get these tickets for free because Jerry donated them to us for his very first performance, The Mentalist Live. If you want more tickets about future shows, you can go to mentalist.com and learn about Jerry. When I send you each your email about the show, it is just going to be a link that you're going to be getting. You don't have to do anything except that. There's a little list of things you'll need to have in front of you so he can play with you. And let's see, Debbie's auction item is up to $550, and my auction item is up to $225. So in a few minutes, we will close that in like...
Maybe 2 minutes.
Those are closing in 2 minutes, so $550 for Debbie, $225 for me. And so in the next 2 minutes, I just want to talk to my husband and... Oh, yeah. So the piece of luggage that's going up on Facebook tomorrow, it is looking really good. We photographed it today. Look, Ferruccio, I know you've been waiting for this. We photographed this beautiful piece of luggage, and it's going to be on Facebook for a week. It's by you, Todd, over there, and he's putting the picture up. Here's the picture of it. We had a chance to make it look. It looks like brand new. It's amazing what will happen when you polish up your luggage. I never think about doing that, but
well, it wasn't used a ton, as you can tell.
No,
it's not beat up.
No, but it looks like a different bag now. It's beautiful. This you could use this today. It's a real vintage Louis Vuitton.
But she, it was in her closet, been here for a while, and you know when she was touring, she would have never use this because it would have never handled it. So this would have been more like a smaller trip, like she should go with Paula,
yeah,
her best friend or something to that effect. And so,
and then they would travel by private jet because Paula had one.
But then you could get away with these small, but you could see it's had some use. It's certainly not brand new, but you know, Buck cleaned it up really nicely because it had
beautiful.
A layer of, it was funny because the side that was down
had, like that.
The side that was up was covered in like a very fine layer of dust.
Yeah.
So it certainly needed some assistance. We do have some other close-ups of it, but
it's an incredible piece of history. It's got Debbie's luggage tag on it, so
there's
it has
the tag,
the Greenway address, and so this is from what would you say the 60s?
Yeah, yeah, probably would. Now, by the way, you could see right there, there's a little bit of damage on the handle. I mean, it's not...
That's all I could see, though.
No, I know. But, I mean, if you look at the other stuff super close, it's clear that it's in really good condition.
Oh, yeah.
I here it is opened up. This is kind of a nice shot.
Dora, you're the best photographer.
So
you
there it is. You could see it's got the hook to hang it in the closet. It's got some other pockets and zippers.
Yeah, that's a beautiful piece. I have never owned a piece of Louis Vuitton luggage because it's so crazy expensive. But I love the everything about it, the construction. It's not heavy. When I picked it up, I was surprised.
Yeah, I mean, it's really well made.
Yeah.
I'll go to the... I'm on the... I have it right here.
Okay.
So there's
so
the...
So this is going to go up. I'm going to say tomorrow because it's ready to go. We have the luggage. I just have to write up the... So it'll go up tomorrow. Auction is closed. I'll announce the winners of that. But this is beautiful.
It is very reasonable. It's very lightweight, as you said.
Yeah, no,
there is also a chicken feather included. I see that right here.
That's because it was... The chickens were... They're losing feathers.
There's the chicken feather right there.
They're molting, yeah. The chicken feather comes with it. It's from my new rooster.
Well, the other thing is it's got that, you could see, let me switch to...
Yeah.
You can see here it has, you see the Louis Vuitton, the original.
Oh, little. Yeah. It's an absolute, what do you call it, authentic Louis Vuitton piece.
Yeah, I mean, I remember her taking this on some smaller trips. You'd really call that her personal luggage as opposed to, I do have some of her, like, show luggage, but it's beat to hell. You know, it's
and I'm sure it's good luggage, but I don't know what it is.
Not like that.
That is unmistakable, yeah.
Yeah, so this was in her closet here, and we found it recently, and I thought somebody would really enjoy having that. And I sure as heck am not going to be running around with it, but somebody might really treasure that. I hope so.
Someone asked what the new rooster's name is. I'm going to have a
no,
contest.
No, there's going to be a, has
yeah,
to be a contest.
Yeah, we don't have a
that.
Name for him yet. I just call him Baby because, you know, I want him to get used to somebody. Okay, the winners of tonight's auction. For Debbie's, guess who won tonight's office auction for Debbie?
He's going to have, honestly, I mean, no joke, he's going to have probably the biggest Debbie collection I've ever heard of.
I think either Lisa Eaton, Frank Ferruccio, and Tammy, shoot. Tammy, is it Tammy Wilson? That they all have the most.
Well, the cigarette case is spectacular.
Lisa Eaton. Yes.
I think that's a really nice thing to even put in play.
Yes.
You know, if you don't smoke cigarettes, you could roll some joints and put it in there or something.
Todd Fisher.
What? People don't roll joints anymore?
Yes.
Okay, get some pre-roll joints.
Oh my God. What? What?
Hey.
What's a girl to say?
In our state, it is perfectly legal. I'm thinking about firing one up right after this show. Just kidding.
Yeah. All right.
Sounded funny though.
I know.
I like saying
and
that.
And the person that won my bundle, oh my God, Kathy Winkler. Kathy
Does
Winkler.
She have all your scripts?
Kathy has
Does she have
them. And this is a different one.
Are you trying to corner the market on the Hicklin scripts?
Congratulations, Kathy Winkler. Thank you so much. And Kathy Winkler also is such a wonderful, she's a good donator to our show, too. So
she's
donated many times.
If she has lots of signed and autographed pictures, we could find something different to give her.
Well, you know what? I'm just going to have to talk to her about that.
Exactly.
But I want to thank everybody so much for tuning in tonight. Tonight was exciting for me because not being able to go out and be entertained right now is very, very, very frustrating for me. And, you know, most people will never see a mind reading show ever in their life, a mentalism show it's called. And when I can't wait to go back to work because that's what I also do. But Jerry has been doing this for a long time. He's done over 4,000 shows in Las Vegas. And so for you to be able to go see a Vegas show, it's really exciting. So I'm very excited that we were able to do that tonight. I want to thank Jerry McCambridge for giving those tickets to us. And I want to say that we're not having a show Monday night, but we are having one Tuesday night, and I will post the show schedule for next week. So we'll have one Tuesday night, Todd and I together.
Would you like to run a nightlight clip?
Yeah, how about, you know what, let's do that. So Todd, I want you to set it up, but this was really an unusual thing. Back in the 80s.
Early
80s.
You'll see Henry in this, in fact.
We'll see our Henry in this. Back in the early 80s, is your mom in this?
Yep.
Oh, awesome. So then we'll say goodnight after this. It's a short clip. So back in the early 80s, Todd had a Christian
satire show.
It would be
like
Saturday Night Live, but mm-hmm. It was a Christian themed, and I thought it was so great. I didn't know you then, but I watched this, and so let's see a little clip of it.
I'll set it up a little bit further. I mean,
okay.
So the idea was I had gone on a Christian talk show, and they had said to me, you know, what do young people like you think about shows like this? And I said, well, it's a live show. I don't think you really want me to answer that question mm-hmm. on live TV. And they said, no, we really do. And I said, well, I mean, look at the set. It looks like a lobby to a Ramada Inn. I said, look at the suit you're wearing. It looks like something they sell at Sears.
Yeah.
I mean, and look at your wife's hairdo. I mean, no offense, but the bluing went out with button shoes. And you know, and what was admirable about them was they said, well, okay, so if you know so much about it, why don't you do a show for us? Mm-hmm. So I took that as a personal challenge, and I said, well, if I'm going to do that, I got to have complete creative control, and I have to be able to make fun of everybody, because I think humor is a great, unlike today's philosophies, I think humor is a fantastic way to communicate different points of view. So we satirized heavily the religious community, but in a fun way. And we tried to point out that it was possible to believe in God, but not get hung up on all of the things that were hanging us up. So I had created a character called Reverend Hype, who did nothing but beg for money. You're going to see Jerry Hauser, who played Reverend Hype. You're going to see Miguel Ferrer, who played a talk show host. Miguel was one of my best friends at the time, and also he was the a regular on the show. He also would sub in when I was, you'll see me doing some bits in here, and he would direct while I was doing bits, and so we'd take turns with that. And you'll see my mother in a little soap opera that we did called Fort Worth with Stan Freberg. And there's some fun stuff in here. Anyway, you have to. That's the context, though. This is 1982, something like that. Might even be earlier. And we were all a lot younger there. My mom does a hilarious bit where she bumps off her husband in a little skit that was actually hosted by Dan Aykroyd, mm-hmm. called The Demon Zone.
Is that in this?
This is in here. It's only a little montage.
It.
It's a montage.
Let's see it.
Well,
I loved the fact that, you know,
I have to bring it up.
Okay.
I didn't, you know.
Maria says, humor is so needed in life. You're so right, Todd, Jody, Brett, Miguel. Yeah, Miguel was a good friend of mine, too. And that's before I met Todd. So we had a lot of friends in common back then before we knew each other. Joe Kim and Co. just walked in the room and said, hi, Todd.
Hey, man.
Hey, Joe.
Well, so Joe will appreciate this, too. So, you know, it's like the thing about this show was it you know, it's obviously 40 years old, but it came at a time, you know, where a lot of people were turned off by people on TV, you know, that were begging for money, for example. That was one of my pet peeves. But people had a variety of reasons why they let other people keep them away from having some kind of a relationship or belief system.
Well, people can be turned off to a relationship with God because of religion. And so, you
that's why the famous statement.
There's dogma in
religion. There was a great statement back then. Religion is man's attempt to get to God.
Okay, well, let's see.
Okay,
this.
No, but I just wanted to be clear that, can you imagine even doing, I don't even think we could pull this off to this day because everybody is so hung up on political correctness. We're not.
That's
but
right.
We, you know, when you're doing satire, which Saturday Night Live was doing at the time, and I was certainly inspired by that format. Lauren Michaels was the producer, and, you know, we really liked kind of what they were doing, just took a little different subject matter. But, you know, to do satire, you're on what I call the bleeding edge comedy can be, it runs on a very fine line, like a razor blade, and you can fall one side or the other. So in order to be funny, we used to have comedians that would, you know, take on these controversial subjects. So anyway, here we go. Nightlight.
We're off.
Nightlight 1982.
1982.
Here we go. And now, your host, president and founders of Absolutely Nothing, Todd and Donna Fisher. We're actually on their set. That is their set.
Hello, Pacoima. Let's just praise the Lord.
Good evening, brothers and sisters, and thank you for letting me into your homes. And speaking of money,
Franco Industries proud to present the soon-to-be best-selling book, The Divine Dialect. Yes, now Christian terminology can be as easy as saying, God bless you.
Say what I mean?
Because it is the job of the evangelist to interpret the gospel.
Good evening and welcome to Introspective, the program that attempts to probe, to question in depth, some of the more probing questions, as well as some of the more questioning probes inherent in this type of introspective dialogue, and to try and separate a certain dichotomy that exists between all of us and our dialogue, introspective-wise.
For a transcript of what I just said, send $1 to Introspective, care of this station. If you want an explanation of what I just said, I'm sorry, you're on your own. Meet a couple, any couple. recently married and embarking on their shared life journey together. Their search begins, and with honeymoon optimism and joy, they enter their first prospect, a house situated just inside the Demon Zone.
Oh, I'm making your favorite drink for you, Papa. Oh, now that's a good boy.
Watch this.
Oh, my
God. You got any more surprises up your sleeve?
Yes, I have. I'm going to have your baby.
You what?
Well, now don't get upset. After all, we are married, remember?
Oh, right, I forgot that for a minute. So many characters in this thing.
Come on, send in those bots. Because if you do, this week and this week only, for a $50 donation, God will give you $100 worth of credit.
Sounds too good to be true? Well, there's more. If you order now, you will receive free of charge our Hollywood option. This remarkable feature allows you to pattern the personality of that little ankle biter after the celebrity of your choice. Just think, have Brooke Shields over for Sunday dinner. Have the Fonz come home for Christmas. Hey, this offer's not available in any store, so call now. 1-666-480-1000. Hey, Visa Master Charger accepted. Easy credit terms available for homeowners. That number again, 1-666.
Anyway,
what's great about the was that Clark Gable's?
No, that is Mickey Rooney's outfit from the Andy Hardy series.
The one with the last bit that you did.
Yeah, with the big shoulder pads. Yeah, yeah, that's Andy Hardy's costume. I was looking for like a really campy outfit, you know, to wear because obviously you're playing this huckster.
Right.
And I was in the museum collection and there was this Andy Hardy piece and it fits me perfect, right? So Mickey Rooney and I are similar build. And so that was fun.
Someone said no cameos from Carrie.
Yeah, there is. Carrie did several skits. In fact, she opened up a show with Dan Aykroyd and myself that is freaking hilarious. But, I mean, there you could talk about hours and hours and hours and hours. This could go on forever.
Oh, I know. Well, you know, I remember when we were in Nashville when I was on tour and you went with me and we stopped in, was it Nashville? Yes, it was. And a lot of people from the church that you and Henry started back then. The hiding place, they lived there now in Nashville at that time, and they came to visit us while we were there.
Mm-hmm.
And it was... Richard Dion. He said that he actually became a Christian because of that show.
Yeah.
And I love that, because you know what? It just because you are a believer does not mean you don't have a sense of humor. And I love that you did this show. I used to watch it back then. People just sometimes forget that it's not only a joyous thing, but it's, you know, your sense of humor doesn't change. You don't get a personality transplant, you know.
On the other hand, at the time and even today, you know, certain religions are very serious. You know, and there's a lot of stained glass windows and, you know, a lot of pews and a lot of repetitive stuff. And, you know, when Christ said, pray like this, our Father who out in heaven, like this, he didn't say that over and over. And he was just trying to give you an idea of what it would be like to talk to your Heavenly Father.
Yeah.
And he wasn't trying to say, do all this repetitive stuff. So I think sometimes many religions have got caught up in a lot of strange traditions. And if you think about the things that have been done in the name of God, it's a nightmare. And so that has obviously nothing to do with God. In fact, a lot of the questions we would get, you know, in the old hiding place days were like, you know, do you know, does, you know, God kill children, you know, like, you know, accidental deaths or just, you know, what the what ifs in life,
yeah.
You know, innocent people die, you know, and is that, and it's God's will. So we spent a lot of time, Henry and I, thinking about that stuff. And you remember our philosophies were far from that.
Mm-hmm.
We were like, well, you know, the God that I know doesn't kill children and innocent people. I mean, we live on a planet where things happen. We cause things to happen. and we have to bear responsibility for that. God isn't around being a cosmic killjoy. He's not around causing all of these things. And you know, that is what the hiding place got built on, was this very non-judgmental, very non, we'll call it rules, you know? Mm-hmm. Religion has a lot of rules, and I think those rules can really hang people up. So the show is designed to bust that up. This, of course, the church. I would have never done the church without Henry, as you well know, because there was, you know, people were trying to get me to play that role, and I was like, not going to happen. I mean, you know, I'm not going to get up there. I'll go up there and talk every now and again.
Well, Henry was an incredible pastor, and I went to that church and before I knew you, and way before I knew you, I attended that church for 3 years before I moved to New York. And so I have to say, you know, it was really an awesome thing to be a part of, because it was like you could understand it. It was, if I dare say it, it was a very hip church. And you know,
at the time,
yes, it was. You know, so yeah. it was really cool.
The music was a big part of that.
Oh, absolutely. And it was worship music before other people did worship music. Like, you know, Joel Osteen's church today has absolutely amazing worship music. Other churches today have fantastic worship
but
music.
Nobody was doing this back then. We had rock and roll music, you know, before anybody was playing doing that. I mean, to have a set of drums in a church was like unheard of.
Okay, you know. Well, we have to let people go sleepy because it's 11 o'clock and plus back east. And
well, I mean, if you want to look at it like that,
how would we?
It's like the sun's coming up in England, so.
What about Australia?
Somewhere.
We have the Australians here.
You can go the other way and say somewhere. It's early in the morning. Hawaii? We got plenty. You can stand up for three hours in Hawaii.
Exactly. Well, we want to just thank everybody so much for coming tonight. And to the ticket winners, congratulations. Do me a favor. If you are gifting somebody your ticket because you can't make it, can you PM me and let me know so we can have an accurate count to give Jerry? And if we have tickets left over, we will give them away on Tuesday night. His show is Wednesday. So, but please let me know, winners, what your intentions are, again, because we want to make sure that we don't give away a ticket that someone isn't going to be able to use. And I see, you know, there's some people in here that really want to go. So,
Well, if you don't win one for free, obviously you can buy a ticket.
Yeah, I think, though, it might... you know what?
But I mean, isn't he going to do this... Like, this is a launch, right?
This is a launch, yeah.
So you can certainly buy other nights.
Every week. But we just want to make sure his launch, that all of our folks are there, because you'll all be able to see each other in the room.
Are you going to be there?
Of course I'm going to be there. It's a first. I'll be there. All right, good night, everybody. Let's sign out properly, and happy Saturday, in case I didn't say it. So he's going to put on his magic gloves to pick up the... Oh, and is Philip Hart here tonight? I didn't see him. Okay, but I was thinking about him today, so...
Why?
I don't know. Sometimes people just pop into my mind, and I don't know why.
Uh-oh.
I'm not in control.
I'm going to have to do this on the wide camera, because once you put the gloves on, you can't control the system anymore.
Oh, because of your fingers.
So I'll do it this way. Ready?
Right. Yes. There's no place like home. And that's a good thing.
Somewhere over the rainbow.
Good night, everybody. Thanks so much. Thanks again, Jerry McCambridge, for the tickets and... just sending so much love to you all. We'll see you next week. I'll post the schedule tomorrow. And have a wonderful, restful night tonight, everybody. Be well. Love you so much. We're going to leave it on for a few minutes to let people say goodnight to each other. So we'll go to a nanny cam to something.
I can.
Or you can just go to this and we'll un.
Well, you know, I'll tell you what I could run for them if you want. I could run them some really cool aerial footage that's right on that reel that I shot of the Blue Angels and Thunderbirds.
Okay, go ahead and run that.
We'll signing off.
Our mics and everybody say goodnight to each other.
We might go to jail for this because it's a famous song. We'll see.
I don't want to go to jail. They'll yank the whole episode.
No, they won't. We'll get it out before then.
The whole episode.
Here we go.
I hate jail. The Witcher.
This is something I shot for the Blue Angels and the Thunderbirds many years ago.
Nice.
To marriage?
To divorce. Looks like you're happy to see me.
We're pregnant.
All we want from each other, to have the kid, nothing else. Just to have the kid. No commitments, no dependency. Nothing but the kid.
Yeah. Exactly.
Deal.
Thank you.
Honey, look. Dad, I love it.